Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Francisco, and welcome to the lesson number 4 of this intermediate level. Guys, I want you to please pay carefully attention to all the little details that we're going to talk about in this class, because we're going to have relative clauses and relative pronouns. And obviously, I'm going to give you some examples related to this. But so what is all the stuff that you have on the board? Well, that's a very good question, guys. In here, I have only one story, but it's not this long. It's just this story, is one story here and one story here, but they are the same. See? Es la misma historia, but this is written in two different ways. Okay? So we're going to analyze the first part that we have here, and I want you to please try to read it with me and analyze it. So, look at this. Francisco Choa is an English teacher. What is this, guys? What is this? What is this? This is a clause. This is a sentence. A clause and a sentence is the same. What is the characteristic of a clause and a sentence? A sentence has a subject. In this case, Francisco Choa is the subject. Verb is here, the verb to be, and a complement. Subject, verb, and complement is a characteristic of a clause and a sentence. It's the same. This is an independent clause. It's not related to any other clause here. Okay? So, guys, let's continue. He was born in Medellin in 1983. Look at the other independent clause that we have. Subject, verb, and complement. Okay? I have another period. He has two daughters, Isabella and Emily. Pay attention to what we have, guys, here. In here, I mention Isabella, and here, I'm mentioning Isabella again. Isabella and Isabella, and repeating this name. Okay? Pay attention to these details. Now, Isabella is 5 years old, and Emily, I'm repeating Emily too, is 3 years old. Probably this is additional information, guys. He is not married yet, but he lives with a special woman. Her name is Reina. Her name here is the subject, verb, and complement. He met her in Venezuela. A special greeting for all those people from Venezuela, guys. I hope that everything changes for the better for all of you guys. I love you. Okay? Let's continue. He met her in Venezuela. I mentioned in the country. He lived in Venezuela again, and repeating the country again, for 2 years. Nowadays, Francisco has an English channel on YouTube. Pay attention to this. And pay attention to this, guys. I'm repeating the subject here. In this case, we have the same, which is Francisco. Francisco is also called Pacho. He shares classes for students on YouTube. I'm repeating YouTube. You see? A lot of repetition here, guys. Those students who want to learn. I'm also repeating students here. Well, this is a very good way of writing a story and to tell a story. But this is not the best. Why not? Because in here, I have a lot of pauses and I have a lot of repetitions. Tenemos muchas pausas y repeticiones. And this probably affects the fluency when speak. Eso afecta un poco la fluidez a la hora de hablar. That's why I want you to see the difference between writing in this way and writing in this way when we have relative pronouns and relative clauses. Okay? Vamos entonces a pasar a esta parte. Look at this. Francisco Choa is an English teacher. It's the same independent clause that we have here. But look at what we have. Who was born in Medellin in 1983? Look at this. In here I have this independent clause and this other independent clause. The same. But look. In this part, I have a subject pronoun. This case is he. In this case, I don't have this subject pronoun. Look at this. He is not here. I just wrote it, but it's not there. In this case, we have this relative pronoun. If I use this relative pronoun who talks about people and is going to help you to do three different things. A relative pronoun helps you to connect two different sentences or more to give additional information or to replace any subject. Reemplazar cualquier sujeto. Esas básicamente las tres cosas que hace. Now, guys, this is a subject pronoun and this is a relative pronoun. I have two pronouns together. It's very weird when you have two pronouns together. Why? Look at this. Francisco Choa es un profesor de inglés quien él nació en Medellín en 1983. It's very weird. Because in here, I'm using this subject pronoun that I know that I don't need. Why not? Francisco Choa es un profesor de inglés quien nació en Medellín en 1983.
Guys,
this relative pronoun that we have is connecting these two independent clauses and is giving a relationship between these two independent clauses. Now, a relative pronoun helps you to construct a relative clause. Es básicamente lo que hace eso. Te ayuda a construir una oración relacionada o relativa, que es algo con una relación entre estas dos oraciones que tenemos. ¿Sí? Es básicamente lo que hacemos ahí. ¿Ok? Let's continue, guys. He has two daughters, Isabella. Yes, I'm mentioning Isabella here. Who is 5 years old? What is this who doing here? What is it doing there? In this case, this who is talking about Isabella is replacing a subject. Remember, guys, that in the story that we had previously, this one, Isabella is repeated. Yes, we're talking about Isabella in two times, okay? But in here, I'm just mentioning Isabella, and I'm using a relative pronoun that talks about Isabella again, okay? Isabella, who is 5 years old. The same happens with Emily. And Emily, look at this, who is 3 years old. This case, this who is talking about Emily, because in here I have Emily here and Emily here. This who is replacing one Emily. Okay, este está reemplazando una vez Emily y este está reemplazando una vez Isabella. Now, guys, look at what we have here. Who is 5 years old and who is 3 years old? This is practically additional information that we have from the text. This is not affecting the rest of the sentence. For example, as we're saying that this is additional information, if we skip these parts, yes, the sentence has to have a sense. Tiene que tener sentido. Voy a omitirlo. Look at this. He has two daughters, Isabella and Emily. Stop. Who is 3 years old? I don't mention that. He has two daughters, Isabella and Emily. Why? Because this is additional information. In this case, we are adding additional information, and remember that this is something that relative pronouns do. They give you additional information. They replace a subject and they connect two or more independent clauses. Are we okay so far? Vamos bien hasta ahí. Pero que sí, muchachos. Let's continue. He's not married yet, but he lives with a special woman whose name is Reina. Look at what we have here and look at what we said here. He lives with a special woman. Her name is Reina. In this case, I was using this possessive adjective here and name. In this case, I'm using a relative pronoun. What does this mean, guys? This means cuyo o cuya. Este es acaso estamos hablando que no está casado aún, pero vive con una mujer especial cuyo nombre es Reina. This who's is talking about this special woman. Este está haciendo relación a esta mujer especial, para no repetir la otra vez. ¿Ok? Miren que no estamos cambiando el sentido de la oración. Let's continue. Whose name is Reina, whom he met in Venezuela. Look at this. This whom, what does this mean, guys? What does this mean? This means a quién o a quiénes. Eso en la clase que les recomendé en esta lo van a poder ver. You can watch those definitions there in that class. Look, in here, this whom is talking about this. It's talking about Reina. Por eso estamos haciendo como una oración relacionada. Todos están teniendo como algo que ver entre sí. Okay? Who he met in Venezuela, where he lived for 2 years. This where is talking about what? This where is talking about Venezuela. Remember, guys, that in here, I repeated in two different opportunities, Venezuela. But in this case, with this where, I'm replacing one Venezuela because it's the subject, and I'm just only mentioning Venezuela in one time. Okay? So in Venezuela, where he lived for 2 years. Nowadays, Francisco, who is also called Pacho, pay attention to this. Remember, guys, that this is additional information. I know that this is additional information because it is written in two commas, within commas. As we mentioned here, Isabella, who is 5 years old, and Emily, who is 3 years old. Look, this is additional information, guys. And this who is talking about what? It's talking about who here. This who is talking about Francisco. Remember that in here, I was repeating Francisco and Francisco. But in here, I'm not repeating. I am avoiding repetition. Estoy evitando repetir tanto lo mismo como lo hicimos acá. Look at this. Francisco, who is also called Pacho, has an English channel on YouTube. I'm going to stop there because remember what we mentioned here,
David, this is additional information. This doesn't affect the rest of the sentence. Francisco has an English channel on YouTube. This is additional information. It didn't affect the sentence. Okay. Where? This where is talking about what? It's talking about a place, a location. In this case, YouTube is the location. Remember that in here, I was repeating YouTube here and YouTube. And with this where, I'm avoiding again repetition.
Estoy evitando otra vez la repetición. ¿Sí ven cómo se va formando? Pacho, es mucha información. I know that's a lot of information, but this is a pretty interesting topic that is going to favor a lot on you, the fluency when speaking. Okay?
Where he shares classes for those students who want to learn. In this case, this who is talking about what? It's talking about those students.
And in this case, remember that we have here students and students here. We were repeating the same thing. Estamos repitiendo la misma cosa.
Now, guys, if we read the story again, probably you're going to understand it much better, and this is going to be much more fluent because we don't have a lot of pauses as we have here.
No tenemos tantas pausas y repetición. ¿Sí? Sin embargo, es depende de ustedes. This is up to you guys. Ya ustedes deciden cuál utilizar y poco a poco la idea es que nos vamos migrando hacia esta parte, que es básicamente lo que más se va a utilizar. Espero que le hagan un capture entonces a todo eso que vimos hoy, que practiquen con algunos ejercicios extra que les voy a dejar y no olviden que van a tener que ver esta clase otra vez. Soy insistente con eso, me perdonan, pero es la tarea que les dejo. ¿Por qué? Porque se va a complementar mucho.
This is going to help you a lot to complement what we saw here today. Okay? So guys, I hope you like this class. Don't forget to share this class with many, many other people and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. Okay? Bye-bye, my friends, and see you next class.